Next, we will introduce a new function called the hyperbolic arcsecant. Let's recall the hyperbolic secant of x function and its graph. And let's answer the following questions. Is this function one-to-one? The answer is no, because it doesn't pass the horizontal line test. Does this function have an inverse? The answer is also no, because only one-to-one functions have inverse functions. Now, let's make a new function g of x from the hyperbolic secant x by restricting the domain of the function to only non-negative x values. Is this function one-to-one? The answer is yes, because now it passes the horizontal line test. Does this function have an inverse? The answer is also yes, because all one-to-one functions have inverse functions. And here's what it looks like. We call this function the hyperbolic arcsecant. However, it is not a new function and we have seen this function before. So what is the equation of this function? Let's find out. Let's find the equation of the inverse of the hyperbolic secant of x function. To find the inverse, we first swap the x and y in the equation, and now the goal is to isolate the y variable. We multiply both sides by the denominator and distribute. Then we multiply both sides by e to the power y and collect all the terms on the left side. We let u be equal to e to the power y, and then we have a quadratic equation for variable u, which we can easily solve. To solve the quadratic equation, we use the quadratic formula to obtain the two solutions. However, since u is positive, we have to discard the solution with a negative sign. Since u is e to the power y, y therefore is the natural logarithm of u. So we solve for y and we finally get the following result. We found the equation for the hyperbolic arcsecant function with the following domain and range. We introduced a new function called the hyperbolic arcsecant of x and discussed some of its properties.